There's a technique called electrochemical impedance spectroscopy. If you don't know what it is, it's something seemingly complex. Something like this. It doesn't really make it easier when you see it like that. But don't worry, I'm not here to give you a lecture on this. I'm here to tell you how a broken gift actually helped me convince our investor to give us the money to buy this equipment that could allow us to do this test. And it really helped our company to go to the next level. What happened was, some years ago, me and my friends came together with a very good idea on how to make batteries better. We started a company and we were extremely good at communicating with the academic world. We were really good at telling them why our idea is so good, and we could get into discussions about all the technicality. But what we were very bad at was communicating and telling the public what we were doing. Our investor always told us that, okay guys, from now on, you have to be able to come down, tell people what you do, because I'm working with you and I have no idea what you're doing. We never took him that serious, but we needed the money this time. The device that we wanted was very expensive. We went back to him and he said, hi, we need money again. We need it for this device. He said, I'm very happy to give you the money, but this time you have to make me understand what the test is. You have to make me understand it in the most simple way possible. If you do that, then we could sit down and say, okay, let's see what we can do with this device. I said, okay, it seems good. How much time do I have? He said, a week. It was a Monday. He said, we can get together on Friday. And he told me in simple words, what is that? It wasn't that challenging at that time, to be honest. I said, okay, I'll do what I do. I'll try to make the complex simple. And I started actually doing that. I started, for the first 3 or 4 days, I started doing what I was really good at, going to fundamentals, bringing out the formulas. And after 3 or 4 days, I turned this into this. That was the problem. I realized I don't know how to make things simple. Simple in my head was different with simple what he was saying. Simple in my head was, show me the formula, convince me that's happening. But in his head, simple was just show it to me. So I was really struggling. It was the evening of Thursday. My mom had realized that I'm not doing really well. So she came to my room and she said, do you want me to help you? Could you tell me, maybe I could come up with a better idea. Maybe I could tell you how to make it simple. My mom is a nurse. There was no way she could help me. So I said, no, let's not do that. And then she said, okay, today is your aunt's birthday. I'm going to the birthday. I've bought a gift. Just come and help me wrap it up and come with me. It's just going to help make you feel better. And we can talk about it in the car. And I said, okay, let's do that. So we started wrapping the gift. The politician my mom is, she started telling me, okay, now we have time. Tell me what it is. I didn't have any options. I said, okay, consider this box the battery thing that we're working on. We're going to put some waves with different frequencies, like high frequency and low frequency. And we're going to put it through this battery and we're going to analyze the waves coming out. These are the waves in and out. And then through analyzing them, the in and the out, we're going to guess what's inside this, how the processes inside this work. She was like, it seems quite complicated, but I can help you, I think. Let's just go and speak about it in the car. Let's go, let's grab it, we're a bit late. I took the gift, we went to the car, I had the keys in my pocket, and I did what a lot of us do and we think we will not forget. When we put things on top of a car, on the roof, and we think we're not going to forget it, you will forget it. So I put that there, I took the key out, I got in the car, we moved, my mom said, where's the gift? And I stopped, and this happened. I was so angry at myself. And I looked at my mom and said, okay, it's broken. Okay, let me just go and get it, and I'll open it up and see if it's broken or not. And she said, just go and bring it. Okay, then we're going to figure out something. I got out, I went to took the box, and I shook it. It was broken. So I went back to my mom, and I said, Mom, it's broken. She said, what do you mean it's broken? It's like, come on, there are two things wandering around in the box. It's broken. And she said, How do you know it's two? And I said, can't you hear it? It's two. My mom started smiling. And she told me, isn't that your test? I was like, it is my test. It was my test. And let me ask you this question. None of you have seen this, have not seen this box before. What's inside it? You don't know how much it weighs. But if I ask you two questions, I want you to answer me. First, is there this one object in this box, or it's more than one? More than one. Okay. Is it a light object or is it a heavy object? Light. Okay, perfect. Congratulations. You do also know the basis behind electrochemical impedance spectroscopy. And in fact, I'll take it another level. You're so good at it that without even holding the box, just your ears and eyes are so calibrated that you can tell what's in the box. The reason for that is this is one of the first experiments we do as a kid. Whenever we receive a box or a gift, for some weird reason, we want to guess what's inside it. So we shake it. What we're doing without knowing is we're applying different frequencies. You start very hard and then it slows down. What you're doing, you're sweeping the frequency. And what happens, very light objects, you can hear them at high frequencies. And when it comes low, heavier objects started sounding. What I did, I took that box on Friday and I gave the same story to our investor. He wanted to give us the money for one device. He gave us three. We were three founders. We each got a device to actually play with. And because we had actually understood it, we had made it so simple, truly simple, we were getting really good at it. We would understand the limitations of the test even. Before that, if I wanted to know the limitations of the test, I had to go and drive these equations. But now I would just look at the box. I can ask you this question. Is it a good idea that if I shake a box really hard, if I don't know what's inside it? No, we're gonna break it. In complex world, that means the amplitude of this wave is important. Another thing that was interesting, I told you I thought there are two objects in this box. But when I opened it up, there were four. But you already know why I thought it was two. Because three of the objects had the same weight. So when I was shaking it, all three of them would hit the wall and give me the same response at the same time. So I thought it was just two. And I told you, we were getting so good at it, they were enjoying every time playing with that device. And people often tell you, find something you enjoy, make that your job. I tell you, find anything. Become really good at it. If that becomes your job, you're gonna enjoy it. And that's what we did. We were enjoying it so much, it wasn't about batteries anymore. We wanted to know more. So that's one of the reasons that we all went back to academia and started breaking down complex to simple. But this time, whenever we would find something, we would actually sit down together and said, how can we tell it to the public? How can we make it simple? And we did that. We would make complex stuff simple. And while that happened, a lot of companies started approaching us because they were hearing simple stuff from academia that they could actually invest in. They could take it to the commercial level. And now that's the whole reason, what I'm doing these days, I'm helping companies to bring concepts from universities and I help them solve the challenges that they have when they go and take it, make it commercial. And believe me, I'm doing this, I'm taking, making this, using the same recipe. I make complex issues simple so everyone could understand it. So everyone could have a chance to actually participate. And I have been surprised that a lot of the times, the most creative ways of solving issues comes from the people that are listeners. They are not good enough ones. So now, tonight, I want to take it to the next level. I want to share this story with you. And I know in our way to the future, we're going to have a lot of complex issues. If you're solving any of those, or in fact, any issue, break it down, make it simple. By doing that, it will allow you to better understand what you're solving. And it will allow everyone to participate and help you in that. And I think if we do it on the challenges that very much threaten our own existence, we would allow a collective responsibility to be generated so all of us could actually solve these issues together. And I think this is a much better and efficient way of assigning a selected few to think by themselves and solve the issues while all of us are just being waiting to be saved. Let's shape our future together and let's keep it simple. Thank you very much. Good.